Okay, let's go through this assignment. This is phase one of the assignment. The second phase of the assignment will be mostly based on the design patterns, right? So you can see in this particular phase one of the assignment, we have covered most of the UML diagrams, if not all, right? And in the next phase, we would have the application of design patterns to the assignment, right? Now, I think before discussing what the assignment is about, let me just answer more of your queries. One common query that I'm getting is that most of you are not able to trace the persons belonging to your groups, right? One way is to email them. So the way you have your WILP email IDs, the others are also having their WILP email IDs. Using the ID number of the student, you can create their email IDs and connect to them, right? However, there are still people who are not able to, there are people who are, might not be accessing their WILP email IDs and they are not responding to the groups. Able to find at least three group members, please go ahead. In case you are able to find at least three of your group members, please go ahead. Do not wait for the fourth one in case you have already mailed to that person. However, keep mailing to that person, but please, I'm guessing there should be go ahead. The answer is please go ahead. Okay, in case you are able to find at least two members of your group, again, go ahead. Okay, you can join, two of you join and work. The other two, keep informing them, trying to connect them. But in case they are not responding, you please go ahead. We will ask those two to join together and the assignment, right? In case you are not able to find any member of your team, that's a difficult situation because we have so many groups. It will be difficult if the enrollment is too large. It will be really difficult if you try to submit the assignments individually, right? So in case you're not able to find even a single member of your team, however, you know somebody else, okay, you know somebody else who's also enrolled in this program, right? You can team up with them, right? If that particular group has less number of people, right? So if they also are not able to trace their own group mix as mentioned in the assignment list, you can team up with them, right? This is the way you make your own group in that case, but please try and avoid submitting a single member assignment. It will be good if you do it at least in a group of two. Minimum at least in a group of two, because you would be able to discuss the case study. You will be able to understand the case study in a much better way with different perspectives when you do in together with others in a group. Right now, reading the submissions, I have already created the submission folders. You must submit according to the set to which you belong to. Right? I have six folders have been created for set one to set six. Right, submit only in the set you belong to. Okay, one member per group should submit. It's not required that every member of the group submits. Only one member of the group needs to submit the assignment. Do not forget to mention the name of all the group members, right? Once we will consolidate all the submissions, we will upload a refined list of the group members and the name of the assignment submitted by them. Right, so this would take another 10 days after the submission closes, and then we could have a cross check, right? And member changes can be rectified through emails, right? There was something else that I wanted to tell you. Okay, the mission portal allows a group to submit only one file, right? You can submit only one file per group. So it is recommended that whatever the documents that you draw, please zip them into one file and then submit. Okay. I'll take up a few questions. What am I paired with someone in another set? How can we submit in this case? Can you please submit in only one set? If your whichever set has the majority of the participants, please submit in that set. Okay. But in case it is 50-50, submit only in one of the set. Submit in all the set. So if you're not able to find your group members, of course you can make a group from the other set. Right? Again, only in one set, otherwise that will create a chaos. Okay. Diagrams using tool like star UML. Yes, you must make use of a tool to make the diagrams, right? But certain diagrams which might not be supported in the tool that you are using, then in that case, make use of MS Word to create the diagrams. I expect beautifully drawn diagrams. Please do not draw the diagram using a pen and a paper and click photo of it and upload. No, please let's put some effort for the amount of weightage the assignment is having. You must draw the diagram either using the tool or using MS Office and try to make the diagrams as clear as possible. Question, type in. I cannot unmute you in even if you raise your hand. Yes, it is star UML. Interested members are available. Please find somebody else you would have met either during the examination or somebody belonging to your organization who's also involved in this, right? In the worst case, if you're not able to find anybody and you are planning to go for individual assignment, please mail me. Okay, mail me and let me know, right? Although I would not allow going for individual assignment, the evaluation would really become difficult, but still try and find out somebody somewhere belonging to the other set you would like to group up. If there are people who are, you would on WhatsApp, if there are groups you are able to trace only two of the group members, join that group, right? But please do try to work on an individual basis. You can make your own teams. I'm telling, in case you're not able to find your group members, make your own team, and whichever set has the highest number of teamers, submit your assignment in that set. Another issue, when you're sending out emails to your group members, please do not CC them to me. It's really weird, you're sending mails to your group members to find out whether they are available and trying to CC to me. I'm getting so many mails. Please avoid that. You need only one zip file. Either you draw each diagram in a separate file or you want, but at the time of submission, it should be one single zip file. We created group members' name during submission. Let's do it like this in the requirement study, right? The document which describes your case study that you have chosen, the first the first description should be about your group members. So please mention the name of all the group members along with the ID numbers and then proceed ahead. Can you have the diagrams by handwritten sketch also? No. Please no. Will all the groups award same marks? So you have online Viva, right? Your assignment submission phase 2. After the submission of phase 2, there will be an online interaction that will be arranged with every group where you will be asked to describe the task that you would have done. There will be questions. All the members of the group will be asked to log in that session, and a Viva will be conducted, and based on that you would be evaluated. Docs, you can use Google Docs in case you want to collaborate with your team members, but once you've used Google Docs, please download as a desktop file on MS Office and then zip and submit it. I think speak about okay, one question: will there be classes next week? There will be one tutorial tomorrow. Okay, there will be a tutorial tomorrow, Sunday, 4 to 6. The live schedule lecture, I've just requested those people to upload details of this live lecture tomorrow, Sunday, 4 to 6. The tutorial will be on another case study, and the diagrams that will be covered are activity diagram and sequence diagram. So please attend this tutorial. Next week there will not be any session because of the makeup examination. Right? You want to repeat the Viva thing, so there'll be Viva per group in which you will be required to log in through WebEx, and all the members would be logging in, and it will not be the kind of setup that we have here that the group members are not able to speak. It would be a different setup where even the group members will be able to speak, and it will be a group along individual Viva where you would be asked questions describing your assignment, various diagrams. You would be asked to explain why this, why that, and etc. And then you will be evaluated on the basis of the Viva. The group that already has 4 members, then can we join in that group? Please avoid joining such group. There are already 4 members, right? Will create more chaos than anything else. If you want to ask a question, please type in. You're raising a hand, I will not be able to unmute you. Some members do not contribute, but the other two work hard. How will the marks be awarded? Yes, Viva will be conducted, and it is the responsibility of the person conducting the Viva to find out whether who has contributed and who has not, right? Tutorial video has not been uploaded yet. Can you please check on this? It has been uploaded. I have replied also. It is uploaded in video that it was immediately the lecture it was conducted, right? So I'm sharing my desktop, so I think you will be able to see it. So this is topic 1, 2, 3. This is the safe home tutorial, right? So the video is here. Let's check on that. Okay. Assignment, I would just go to the assignment once. So the eighth assignment is to develop the capability of the student to apply various object-oriented analysis and design techniques to the design of a software to be performed by the group members. Is first you have to choose a software application. Choose a software application that you would want to develop. The chosen software application can be from it can be application or a live project, right? However, be careful in sharing the names and related details of the application in case of live projects for proprietary related concerns, right? About choice of the software, you must roll down to the third and the fourth page of this particular assignment, right? So the just a minute. Okay, the third and the fourth page, they list out certain topics for the assignment that you can choose, right? These certain assignment topics that you can choose from. It is not limited to this, but these are certain examples. The examples are given with the idea so that you are able to make out the level of complexity of the assignment that you are expected to take up. So there are these 9 topics that are given here, along with the page certain games that are there, right? So that you can alternatively use to design for this particular assignment. Okay, because there's one game which is discussed in your textbooks as well, which is the Monopoly game. So based on that, I've given a list of few games, and if some of the games you do not understand, you can use the internet to understand the game and then design that particular game as a case study, right? Apart from these 9 case studies are the ones that you can choose from, and also any other than these, right? Another important thing is that topics which should not be taken. Okay, so you must make sure that your topic does not fall under this particular list of the topics, because these are the topics for which either the information is readily available on the internet, or it is discussed in either available at the on the Platify folder, or either discussed in the live lectures or in the recorded lecture, right? So you must be very careful that you should not take up a topic from this particular list, right? Coming back to the assignment question, right? So once you have chosen a particular topic, you must describe the software development process that would be used to this particular system you have chosen, right? And keep referring to the deliverable section, where you would get to know as to what is expected to be written in a particular step, right? Then once you have written about the software process model, please describe the software application that you would want to develop. Then move ahead and draw the use case diagram. The complexity of your system should be such that there are at least 2 actors in your system and at least 8 to 10 important use cases. But please do not consider login, logout to be an important use case. So these 8 to 10 use cases would be apart from the use case from the normal login logout use cases, right? So you must have a detailed use case diagram, right? Then at least 2 important use cases should be written in the fully dressed format. Next, you must draw the domain model using proper notations. Additionally, you should also draw two important sequence diagrams for the two important use case scenarios. Finally, draw sequence diagram for two selected scenarios and activity diagram again for two activity flows. Right, this is what is expected. These are the diagrams which you are expected to draw. Then, at expected deliverables, you find that even it mentions the number of sites that you would be required in to make in the case of software development process that you choose. Then you should have a one-page write-up describing your application. And then for each diagram, you must show the scenario so that at least some of the enhanced notations are used in the diagram. Right? So it should not be a very simple scenario that you are drawing the diagram. It should be a good scenario for which you draw the diagram, and it should be using some enhanced notations in the correct manner. Right? This is what is expected in the deliverables. I will take up a few questions now and then we'll close. That was the question, where we'll find this document. This is the assignment which is uploaded on the eLearn portal, right? So this is the OOAD assignment on the eLearn portal. This is uploaded here for submission on 22nd October. Okay. The problem if more than one team knowingly or unknowingly pick the same topic? No, there's no problem. Solution for the chosen software application should not be readily available on the internet. What does it mean? So if our application for which I'm able to find out most of the diagrams on the internet, then please do not choose the application. Do we have access to assignments submitted by other group members? No, you do not have that access. The last of the assignment is 22nd October. That's it for today. There are no more questions. Again, there's some request about postponing it from 22nd October to by the week. I think that would put us in a very tight schedule. Might not be possible to extend by a week or more, because otherwise it just goes on and on and on, right? An important question that I would like to take up: are there marks, separate marks for assignment 1 and assignment 2? So there's going to be only one assignment, and there will be phase 1 and phase 2 for that assignment. The entire assignment is for 20 marks, right? And there will be separate marks for phase 1 and phase 2. I will upload that announcement. So how many marks for each particular step of phase 1 and how many marks for each particular step of phase 2. With this announcement, I'll upload the phase 2 as well. Right? Can you know what the process model here means, like agile model? Yes, you need to specify which kind of software development process model needs to be should be used in the for development of the particular system that you would choose. Phase 2, or is it going to be a Viva in phase 2? No, in phase 2 you will be asked to provide additional implementation of various design patterns that would cover, that we would be going to cover. So you would be asked to provide implementation or description of the design patterns, or maybe application of the design patterns in your particular case that you choose. So that will be a part of the phase 2. The 2nd October deadline is only for phase 1. Can choose any topic or game listed in the assignment? Yes, you can choose any topic or games listed in the assignment. Programs, PPTs and everything, you must zip into one file. You would be allowed only one submission. Only one file can be submitted using the portal. I've configured the portal for the deadline as well, right? So please submit according to the deadline. Can other topics then in this? Yes, this not limited list. This list is given just to let you know the complexity of the expect case study. You can choose any topic from the list, or you can choose any topic from outside the list as well. The idea is you should maintain the complexity of the chosen assignment. We question of whether you want to go for an individual assignment or not, maybe offline, not in the lecture, right? Please write a mail to me in case in a deadlock and cannot just find anybody and would like to do an individual assignment. I said for now a lot of questions that I think I have already answered. Your details about the quiz too, you will get to know. Just let the makeup exam end off and then we'll have the quiz too. I think for today's session, right, we'll meet next weekend and then we'll talk about, tomorrow Sunday we have a tutorial, and next weekend, because of the makeup examination, there is no session, and then we'll meet after that. So that is on 20th October session, and we will start with design patterns. The lecture tomorrow, there is a tutorial session tomorrow. I have requested the live lecture team to update the session for tomorrow. Okay. The question, what is Tambora game? Can somebody help her out? Help her or him out? Please search on the net all the games that I have listed. The complex games, you can find out from the internet how to play these games in case you're not aware of these games. But you can use these games to as a case study and model them accordingly. Okay. Okay, thank you. That was it. Tambola is housey. Okay, thank you. Okay, thank you so much. We'll meet next time.